Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Spyro 3, Year of the Dragon for the PlayStation 1. In our last episode, we defeated Scorch, the third boss of the game, and in addition to some interesting plot twists in the storyline, we also gained access to the fourth and final homeworld of the game, Midnight Mountain, and in this episode, we are going to start exploring Midnight Mountain. So yes, this is pretty much the last major leg of the game for the most part, so we're actually not that far, ladies and gentlemen, from finishing this game. We could be wrapping it up very shortly before too long, but let's take a step outside and do some exploring, shall we?
Spyro, I know you don't trust me, but I want to help you stop the Sorceress. There's a way to open a hidden portal to her lair, but it'll take some very strong magic. If you can find more of the dragon eggs, I think my magic will be strong enough to open the portal. I'll come find you when you have enough eggs, okay?
Well, how about this little development? Yes, Bianca has officially switched sides. She no longer works for the Sorceress after finding out why the Sorceress exactly wanted all the dragon eggs. And, yeah, she's working for us now. So yeah, that is quite a revelation in, that we saw in the last episode, going by all the cutscenes leading up to the fight against Scorch. But, more on that in a moment. Here's our first egg. Saki. So, yeah, that's actually pretty, how should I put it? I want to use the word dark, but maybe that isn't the right word. But then again, maybe it is, because Spyro 3 and the Spyro series in general, being ostensibly a game intended for younger audiences for the most part and whatnot, it's a pretty lighthearted game and series as a whole, but the Sorceress is actually a pretty nasty villain for a series like this. I mean, the rant she goes on in the cutscene prior to the boss fight against Scorch, where she just goes off about how she wants to basically just destroy all the dragons and kill all the dragon hatchlings to use their wings so that she can make a potion for immortality. It's pretty nasty. But in any case, look who's back. Yeah, it's our friend Moneybags. This guy, like, I think we've met him, like, maybe one or two times before. Yeah, sure. Looks like you got another animal for me to rescue. Let's do it.
Well, well, Spyro, look what I have here. It's a life-size space monkey action figure, complete with a fully operational laser. I'd love to let him out so you can play with him, but the Sorceress seems to think he's a menace.
I like action figures. 1,300 gems. I almost said 3,000. Oh my god, if it were 3,000, wow, that'd be too much. So, 1,300? I'd love to say, nah, you can keep him, but I kind of have to let him. You kind of have to let him out, Moneybags, or else I can't beat the game. So, yeah. Release the monkey!
You've always had a weakness for helping silly little creatures, haven't you, Spyro? Oh, well, I suppose there couldn't be any harm in letting him out, could there?
You tell me. I mean, he's got a fully functional laser, so what's the worst that could happen?
No. Well, it's your lucky day. Check this out.
No!
monster, isn't he? Not much stamina, though. Too bad. I had a lot more ammo left. Anyway, I heard all about how you've been fighting the sorceress and her armies and kicking all that butt, and I just wanted to say, huzzah! Yippee! Woo-hoo-hoo! Wish I could stay, but my homeworld's been overrun by Rhinox since I've been captured. If you happen to see the sorceress, tell her I'll be giving her dancing lessons real soon. Know what I mean?
You bet.
Later!
Eh, maybe we should have just let him stay in the cage. Oh well, can't go back on that now. So yes, say hello to, well, maybe not hello to him, but Agent 9 has been unlocked, and Agent 9 is the final animal friend of the game. And yep, we're going to be visiting his level in the next episode. Yep, we're going to go ahead and knock that level off so we can unlock Agent 9 to use in other levels. Namely, Fireworks Factory, because yes, back in Fireworks Factory, there was an area that we could not access, and that area is part of Agent 9's level list. In other words, we need Agent 9 to finish Fireworks Factory. Anyway, Gem Container and an Egg Thief. When's the last time we saw an Egg Thief, anyway? To my recollect, did we have any Egg Thieves in Evening Lake at all? I honestly don't remember. Now that I think about it, we didn't. Yeah, we did not have a single Egg Thief in Evening Lake. Well, we're just gonna have to deal with him like we've dealt with all the others. Although this one can be a little risky, because it is actually pretty easy to fall off the side of the level. But that isn't what happens. And let's just say we'll be doing that particular thing again later on. I won't spoil anything, though. So yes, this is the final homeworld. As I've said a few times already, I think everybody gets the idea by now. We're pretty close to the final we're getting pretty close to the ending stages of the game. Alright, there's Crystal Islands. That'll be the first level we visit after Agent 9's lab. Over here is the portal to Desert Ruins. We'll be visiting that level second. And, whoa! What the heck was that? Did I just trigger a glitch? I got stuck in the portal structure, and then all of a sudden I got shot out of a cannon, basically. Holy crap. What happened there? Over here, we come across the portal to Haunted Tomb. That'll be the third level that we visit. So yeah, I'm already giving you guys the order in which I'm going to do the levels. Go over here and we have another egg. Billy! One hundred and eleven eggs. Okay, what else do we want to do here? Let's see. Ah, and then we have the final main level of Midnight Mountain, Dino Mines, and that's the level we will be doing last. So, essentially, Dino Mines will be the final main level of the game, going by the order that I just gave you guys. That is the order in which I will be doing the levels here. You know, just because it makes sense. I mean, like, Crystal Islands is like the first portal you come across, basically, so might as well do that first. And yes, we have another spark sign. Still have to go back to Evening Lake and do the Sparks level there. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten about that. I'll be doing the Sparks level after I finish up Agent 9's business in Fireworks Factory. Anyway, yet another egg. As usual, the homeworld eggs aren't too difficult. It wouldn't make much sense if they were difficult. And in this portal right here, we have Harbor Speedway, our final Speedway level. So yep, 4 Speedway levels in the game, and that's the final one right there. And if we go right over to here, we actually come across a boarded up portal that requires 149 eggs and 15,000 gems to get into. Interesting. But we'll have to worry about that later. We can't do anything with that portal right now. So let's not concern ourselves. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Now just one last area to check out. And let's see what's going on here.
You did it, Spyro. You found enough of the dragon eggs for me to unlock the portal. Once I've opened it, you can confront the sorceress whenever you're ready. But be careful. She'll be expecting you.
That's right. We already have enough dragon eggs to go straight into that portal and take on the sorceress. It's just like when I did my Spyro 2 Let's Play. When I got to Winter Tundra, I already had enough requirements in the game to take on Ripto. Of course, I am not going to jump the gun. You only need 100 eggs to open this portal. I've got more than enough to do so. But of course, I'm not going to jump right in. Now, I could do it, and that's actually what some people do. Some people go ahead and fight the sorceress immediately. And there's actually a good reason to do that. But I'm just going to stick with what I've already got planned out as far as what to do in the game. Last egg of the level. Yep, 5 eggs, 113. The unlucky number plus 100. And of course I have to find a missing gem, which is somewhere. Sparks, where are you pointing me? Oh. Alright. Midnight Mountain Homeworld is now complete. And I'd say that's a pretty good note to end on. And I think we're gonna stop here. But first, a quick look at the Atlas. We now have all 5 dragon eggs in the level and all 400 gems for 100% completion. Although you may notice at the very bottom, there is an extra egg called Egg for Sale. We won't know what that's for a very long time. But in any case, with the completion of the Midnight Mountain Homeworld, our totals are bumped up to 10,525 gems and 313 eggs for 73% completion. And we are going to cut it here. So that is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Spyro 3 Year of the Dragon for the PlayStation 1. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it as always. And I will see all of you in the next episode as we take on Agent 9's lab. See you folks in the next episode. Ultimate Lifeform RB out. Like what you see in this video? Want to see more? Then please support my channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. I would greatly appreciate it, and also don't forget to like me on Facebook.